وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى this is our second introduction and in this introduction إن شاء الله تعالى I'm going to بإذن الله الكريم speak about the كتاب أخلاق حملات القرآن. We've already spoken about the author and who he is. Now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about the kitab itself, a bit about the kitab. I'm not going to go too much in details regarding the kitab, because inshallah ta'ala, we're going to see the book. We're going to study it. We're going to learn it. But I just want to give you an overview of the book, so you have an understanding. And also, it's going to help you, encourage you to finish the book, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab, as you can, as you've already heard, and as you can see in the PDF that you have, or the actual book that you have, it's called Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran. So it talks about the etiquettes of the carriers of the Quran. And the author, rahimahullah, he speaks about two things in his book. As you can see, he focuses mainly on two points. The first thing that he talks about is the virtue of the Qur'an and its people and etc. And I'm going to mention the chapters, the nine chapters of the book. I'm going to mention it, inshallah ta'ala. The second part that the book also deals with is the etiquettes. So the book talks about the etiquettes of the ones who are carrying the Qur'an, and it also talks about the virtue of the people who are carrying the Qur'an. So the virtue of the people who are carrying the Qur'an and the etiquettes and manners that are required and needed from the one who's learning the Qur'an, the one who's teaching the Qur'an, and etc. Those are the two main points that the book is going to speak about. This concept of speaking about the virtue of the Qur'an and the virtue of the people of the Qur'an, it was something that the early scholars gave much importance to. منذ عصر التدوين, since the time of authorship started in Islam and books were being written, the scholars, they gave a lot of importance to the science, or the they gave importance to the virtue of the Quran, because scholars of different sciences were authoring, and scholars chose to write in the virtue of the Quran. And from the earliest books that were written in the virtue of the Qur'an is the kitab Fada'il al-Qur'an, written by Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam, rahimahullah. And Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam died the year 224 Hijriya. So al-Imam al-Aajurri did not take knowledge from him. Also, the second author who wrote the kitab on the virtue of the Qur'an, Fada'il al-Qur'an as well, is Abi Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ayyub, who is well known as Ibn al-Taris, who died in 294. The third kitab is Kitab al-Fada'il al-Quran, and it's written by Abi Bakr Ja'far ibn Muhammad ibn al-Husayn al-Firyabi, who died in 301 Hijriya. And after that, the fourth author who wrote in this field is Al-Imam al-Aajurri, who died in 360 Hijriya. So Al-Imam al-Aajurri, rahimahullah, after those three books were written in the virtue of the Qur'an, what he did was, he authored a book in the virtue of the Qur'an and its people, and the people of the Qur'an, and also he added something else in there, which is the etiquettes and the manners for the one who's reading the Qur'an and the one who the Qur'an is read on, i.e. the teacher. Al-Imam al-Aajurri, in his kitab, the kitab Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran, he cures, or he discusses, or even he tackles nine chapters. After the introduction, he speaks about nine different topics. The first one he speaks about is the virtue of the ones who are carrying the Qur'an. The people who have memorized the Qur'an, who've learned the Qur'an, the people who are known as Hamalatu Al-Quran, the carriers of the Qur'an. He speaks about their virtue. The second thing is, or the second chapter is, the virtue of man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allama, the one who learns the Qur'an, the virtue of the one who learns the Qur'an and he teaches the Qur'an. That's the second chapter. In the third chapter, he speaks about the virtue of al-ijtima' fi al-masajid li dars al-Qur'an, the virtue of gathering in the masajid to study the Qur'an. In the fourth chapter, the author, rahimahullah, he mentions the akhlaaq of Ahlul Qur'an, the people of the Qur'an. The fifth, the author, rahimahullah, speaks about the etiquettes of the one who reads the Qur'an, but he doesn't do it for the sake of Allah. Number six, he speaks about the chapter of Akhlaqul Muqri, the etiquettes of the Muqri, the reciter. Ida jalasa, when he sits down to read for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is it that is required from him? ماذا ينبغي له أن يتخلق به? What are the etiquettes that he should come with when he wants to sit down to teach the Qur'an? When he wants to recite the Qur'an? What kind of manners is needed from him? The seventh, the author, rahimahullah, he speaks about ذكر أخلاق من قرأ القرآن على المقرئ. The manners of the one who read the Qur'an on a teacher. Number eight, he speaks about أدب القراء. The manners and the etiquettes of the reciters عند تلاوتهم, when they are reciting the Qur'an, مما لا ينبغي له لهم جهل, things that they should not be ignorant about. And number nine, he speaks about beautification of the voice and how important it is to one for a person to beautify themselves. The scholars, after Al-Imam Al-Ajurri came, rahimahullah, they gave many importance to the topics that he spoke about. And from the scholars who came after him, who took that path of authoring a book similar to the book of Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, is none other than the great scholar, Al-Imam Abu Zakariya Al-Nawawi, rahimahullah. Abu Zakariya Yahya ibn Sharaf Al-Nawawi, who died in 676 Hijriya, he wrote a kitab called At-Tibyanu fi Adabi Hamalatul Quran. And we've already covered that book, and we studied it. I've already covered that book 2-3 years ago. That kitab is amazing. And it's bigger than the kitab of Al-Imam Al-Ajurri. It's bigger than it. And he mentions much more than that which Al-Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah mentioned. And it's the most comprehensive book written in this field, Nawawi's kitab. Also, Al-Imam Badruddin Muhammad ibn Abdullah Zarkashi, who died the year 794 Hijriya. He has a kitab called Al-Burhan fi Ulum al-Quran. And in there, when it comes to the al-Naw' al-Tasi' wal-Ishrun, the 29th type of Ulum al-Quran, he speaks about Adabu tilawati wa kayfiyatiha, the manners and the etiquettes of reciting the Quran. So he mentions some of the issues that Al-Imam Al-Ajurri and Al-Imam Al-Nawawi discussed. Jalaluddin As-Suyuti, who came after Al-Imam Zarkashi, who actually took from the kitab of Al-Imam Zarkashi, the Burhan of Zarkashi, and also took from the works before that, he wrote a kitab called Al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Quran. And the kitab Al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Quran, Suyuti, by the way, died the year 911 Hijriya. Suyuti, rahimahullah, also has a chapter in his kitab Al-Itqan, Al-Naw'u Al-Khamis wa Thalathun, the 35th type, and in there he speaks about Adabu Tilawatihi wa Talih, the manners and the etiquettes of the one who's reading the Qur'an and the one who the Qur'an is read on. So scholars after Al-Ajurri, Al-Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah, and also Al-Nawawi, scholars just started writing in this field, and they actually considered it to be one of the sciences related to the Qur'an, that the person needs to know the etiquettes and the manners of the one who's carrying the Qur'an. This kitab written by Al-Imam Al-Ajurri has unique, distinct things. And it has things that give it mazaya. وَيَتَمَيَّزُ كِتَابَ الْآجُرِّيُّ بِالْأُمُورِ التَّالِيَةِ. And these are the things that give this kitab, you know, that importance and that virtue And that reason for why scholars came to this book and they explained it and they studied it and they learned it. I'm going to mention three, inshallah ta'ala. There are actually more than that, but I'm just going to mention three, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is, Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, he was the first person who actually gave tarqiz, importance to Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran. Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran. The etiquette and the manners required from the one who's reading the Qur'an. Prior to Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, they just spoke about the virtue of the Qur'an and the people of the Qur'an. Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam's works, that's what it focuses on. The works written by Al-Firyabi and the works written by other scholars before Al-Ajurri, they were speaking about the virtue of the Qur'an and etc. and the people of the Qur'an. Lakin he was, it could be said that he was the first person who stood up to speak deeply about the etiquette of those who are carrying the Qur'an. And after him, of course, as I mentioned, Nawawi gave importance to it. Zarkashi gave importance to it. Suyuti gave importance to it. And every other scholar who came after that, that's what they did. The second virtue that this book has, or great importance in it, is that Inayatul Mu'allif, Mu'allif, the author of this book, he gave a lot of importance to what? Bil istishhad ala ma yaqulu. Everything he wants to say, he uses as a witness for his statement, bil ayat al karima, statements and the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal ahadith al nabawiyyah al sharifa, and also the statements of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal athar, and statements that were transmitted and quotations that were transmitted from who? An as-sahabati wa tabi'in. The students of the companions and the students of the students of the companions. Sorry, the students of the companions and the students of the Prophet ﷺ and the students of the students of the companions. Yani the tabi'een, the tabi'u tabi'een, and also the sahabas. He uses their statements. وَعُلَمَاءِ الْأُمَّةِ الْمَشْهُورِينَ. And also the statement of the well-known scholars. He brings their quotes. And also the third virtue, or the third great thing in this kitab and that gives it that weight is uslubu, the manners, uslubu al-khitabi al-mu'athar, the way that the author rahimahullah speaks. As we're going to see inshallah ta'ala, al-imam al-ajurri rahimahullah, when he talks, the way he points out things and the way he discusses issues, he speaks in a very heart-softening manner. His uslub, his method, it catches the reader's attention. And he focuses on using one of the methods that are studied in balagha, known as the uslub al-khatabi, which is to address the people, but talk to their hearts. He doesn't use scientific terms that the reader doesn't understand and is taken back by, because that this is not what the book is about. The book is to catch the attention of the reader, to address the general mass, to address the student of knowledge, to address the scholar, to address everybody. So he wrote it in a language that really is appealing to every reader. The kitab, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to be studying, a great scholar by the name of Khalid Uthman al-Sibt. What he did was he summarized the kitab. He summarized the kitab, Akhlaaq Hamalati al-Quran. He made it a mukhtasar, a summarized version, and he took out the asanid, he took out the chains of narrations in the hadiths and in the statements of the sahabas and the tabi'in. He took out the chain. What he also did was he got rid of the repetition of the author, but he didn't take out the statements of the imam in the book. And the reason why he did this was because he wanted it to be easy for the readers, because the chain sometimes is hard for a beginner or a person who's not used to chains of narration. It might become hard for them to read the book. So I was thinking and contemplating whether I should do the mukhtasar or whether I should do a complete version of the book. And what my heart became settled with is to do the complete version of the book and to just leave the mukhtasar, even though it is what is easier for the people. But I want to, inshallah ta'ala, study the kitab in its complete version and read the chains. Also, the explanations in the book, I've only come across, والعلم عند الله عز وجل, knowledge is only with Allah. I've only seen the explanation of Shaykh Abdul Razzaq ibn Abdul Muhsin al-Abbad. He's the only sharah I've seen written. I haven't seen any other shuruh written. And if there is anyone come across it, I would like for them to bring it to my attention. So what I'm going to do, inshallah ta'ala, is I'm going to use Shaykh Abdul Razzaq al-Badr al-Sharah with benefits that I got from other books and elsewhere. So it's not just going to be Shaykh Abdul Razzaq al-Badr al-Sharah, even though I will use his Sharah in many of the places, but I will also bring so much other things from outside, from other places, inshallah ta'ala. Yani other references and other books and other places, inshallah ta'ala. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.